Helix Native is an expensive plugin, but it presents the opportunity to have phenomenal M modeling right on your desktop. If you're thinking of buying Native, you're probably someone who already has some home recording experience with some spare pedals lying around. In this video, I go through the step-by-step process of integrating your existing pedalboard with Helix Native, giving you the best of both worlds. Stick to the end for a bonus tip that will help mixing your song with Helix quality tones and details to download the patch I used for this video. Let's go. Hello Musos, my name is Justin and welcome to All About Worship Guitar. On this channel, I do worship covers, gear reviews and all things worship ministry related. If you're new here, consider subscribing and hitting that bell notification button. If not, welcome back. One of the most popular approaches to tone is running a pedalboard and front-ending two Kempers for a stereo rig. Now considering that the last Kemper amp I saw on Carousel was $2,800, I don't think I'd be switching over to that system. But it got me thinking, those Kemper amps are essentially amp-shaped computers. Was there a way that I could use a two-channel audio interface and process the pedalboard tone in the computer? Enter Helix Native. I bought it to have Helix tones in my work laptop back in the office so that I wouldn't have to shuttle my Helix back and forth, and that worked out great. But in 2020, with the world doing a lot less traveling and hashtag work from home, that plugin was not getting any use at all. Like all good Singaporeans, I could not let a good deal go to waste. I present to you the Helix Native Plus Pedalboard setup. There are several advantages of having such a setup. Firstly, as Native is a plugin that affects the recorded guitar in post, you're able to change the tone even after recording, like this. This has been very useful to me as I'm able to tweak the EQ and ambience of the guitar track without having to re-record. Reamping for the win. Secondly, you have the flexibility to integrate other plugins before or after Helix Native. Need additional compression or an aura exciter? This wouldn't be possible with the hardware Helix, but with Native, your imagination's the limit. And the limitations of your laptop's processor and RAM, just saying. Thirdly, I have Native installed on multiple machines, my MacBook Pro in my recording space and my primary PC in my study where I work to mix, master and edit videos. Having duplicated my patches and my workflow on both machines, I don't have to lug around the Helix and set it up between the two spaces. Okay, enough talk, let's get down to business. In this next section, we'll be talking about how to set up your hardware, followed by tips to set up the software side of Helix Native on the DAW. For hardware, you will first need to consider what audio interface you're using. Not all interfaces are created equal, and the preamp does play a big part in the recorded sound. For a stereo pedalboard, you will need at least a two-channel audio interface, like my Steinberg UR22. It's not the sweetest sounding of preamps, but it's clean and it has plenty of headroom. Yeah, I actually just hit the record button. Okay, redo. So you're my hair and makeup person. Okay, just start. For a mono pedalboard, something simpler will suffice, like the iRig Pro that I have lying around here. The problem with this interface is that there isn't a headphone output, so you have to rely on routing your DAW's audio to the headphone out of your laptop or your PC. The second piece of the puzzle is your cabling. Yes, cables do matter. I can't tell you how many times I've had buzzing issues when I've gigged outside, only to discover that the venue's instrument cables were where they cut corners. I have a pair of Covenant cables, long enough for me to install my pedalboard on one end of the stage and have the interface sit comfortably on the other side of my desk. If you're finding that the treble content in your recording is ear-piercing, I recommend trying a coily cable, which does shave off some of the top end. But be careful though, as a coily cable with a dark guitar will make the recording even darker. The last piece of the puzzle is tweaking the input gain on the interface. Some interfaces come with a high impedance switch on the input, which is meant to boost the signal of passive basses and acoustic guitar pickups when recording direct. Ensure that this is off, as you don't want the preamp to be too hot when recording and you want good headroom. Particularly for stereo pedalboards, if one input has the high impedance switch on, you're going to have level mismatch left and right inputs. So check, your signal chain should be your guitar, instrument cable to your pedalboard, then either one cable to your interface if recording in mono, or two cables to your interface if recording in stereo, for a total of three instrument cables. Let's move on to the software side of things. Listen to these steps carefully and you'll get sound in and out of your interface in no time. First, open your DAW and ensure that your DAW scans the folder where you installed the Helix Native VST plugin. The native installer will try to install to a default location, which may not be where you install your plugins. Second, on the track, decide if you're going to record mono or stereo pedalboard. If your pedalboard is mono, select the input which you've plugged into your interface. If you're going stereo, you'll need to ensure that the track is listening to a stereo pair of inputs. In my case, on Ableton Live, it's 1/2 as a stereo pair. Third, drag and drop the Helix Native VST onto the audio track and let it load. To get your signal into Helix, you need to arm the track for recording. There should be a big red circular button for this purpose. At this point, you'll see an audio signal lighting up at the input of the plugin, but you still won't hear any sound. Fourth, enable track monitoring so that the plugin sends the process audio out to wherever your track has assigned its output. For example, the master volume. Fifth, check the levels going in and out of the plugin. If you're like me and record with low input gain, you shouldn't hear clipping. But if you do, it could be that you need to trim the input gain. slowly slide the input gain slider down until you see about negative 9 dB on the output level meter. This is my personal preference when it comes to setting gain levels, so experiment this to your liking. The next part will apply to the stereo pedalboard users. A major issue you'll run into is mono summing within the plugin. As of yet, Helix Native does not process a stereo signal through an M block. For proper stereo imaging, you will need to run two M blocks with corresponding cabs or IR blocks. You will need to arrange them with a split and merge block pathway and make sure that each pathway is hard panned left and right. For a more focused sound, you can experiment with moving the pan towards the middle. But remember, the more you move that pan to the middle, the more mono summed your signal will be. For an even crazier stereo image, you could do the LX Strabola trick of putting a mono simple delay after one of the amp blocks. Set it to the minimum time, 0% feedback, and 100% mix, and you're essentially displacing the entire path by 15 milliseconds, making it even bigger. If you're looking for one kind of amp tone, you could duplicate the amp and cap blocks. But the fun part of this setup is that you can start to experiment with mixed amp tones. Have one amp as an AC30 and the other a Kelly Texas Channel 1, pair those with their respective 2x12 and 4x12 cabs, and you're entering into vintage Nigel Hendroff tone territory. Now you're in business. With this track setup, you're now hearing Helix Native's amp processing at the end of your pedalboard. Set up another track to load songs, and you have a Helix Native recording template that you can copy and paste for those worship band recordings. Bonus tip, Native works best on guitars, but it equally works well on any vocal or instrument source that you record via your interface. What I found helpful is having a unified approach to tone, especially the ambient effects like delay and reverb. The stock plugins in Ableton are okay, but they're not Helix level quality. I can quickly get very satisfying results when I use Helix Native as a mix gel in my recording sessions. For starters, try setting up an instance of Helix Native in an effects send and use a stereo reverb, the LA Studio compressor, and an EQ block to shape the tone of the ambience. Alright, enough watching a video, get up and go set up your Helix Native plugin. I'd love to hear how you're using Helix Native, so leave a comment to share your experience, as well as any rants or raves. I'd love to hear from you. That's it from me. God bless you and your ministry wherever you are. And remember, whatever you do, do for the glory of God. Thank you for watching. This is Justin signing off.